हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर वेल एट होम एंड डूइंग हार्ड वर्क टू अचीव द गोल्स। स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द इकोनॉमिक्स क्लास ऑफ प्लस वन स्टैंडर्ड। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद लेसन नंबर 4, टाइप्स ऑफ इकोनॉमीज। इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल डिस्कस मीनिंग ऑफ इकोनॉमी, टाइप्स ऑफ इकोनॉमीज, क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ इकोनॉमीज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ ऑनरशिप ऑफ द मीन्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन। इन दिस वी विल डिस्कस कैपिटलिस्टिक इकोनॉमी, सोशलिस्टिक इकोनॉमी, मिक्सड इकोनॉमी एंड डिस्टिंक्शन बिटवीन दीज थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ इकोनॉमीज। क्लासिफिकेशन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ लेवल ऑफ डेवलपमेंट, डेवलप्ड इकोनॉमीज, अंडर डेवलप्ड इकोनॉमीज एंड डेवलपिंग इकोनॉमीज। नेक्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस सोल्यूशन ऑफ द सेंट्रल प्रॉब्लम्स फॉर द कैपिटलिस्ट इकोनॉमी, सोशलिस्ट इकोनॉमी एंड मिक्सड इकोनॉमी। डेवलपमेंट एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ इंडिया, अ कंपेरिजन विद पाकिस्तान एंड चाइना, रीजनल एंड ग्लोबल इकोनॉमिक ग्रुप्स। सो टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद मीनिंग ऑफ इकोनॉमी, टाइप्स ऑफ इकोनॉमीज एंड कैपिटलिस्टिक इकोनॉमी, इट्स मीनिंग, फीचर, मेरिट्स एंड डीमेरिट्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, मीनिंग ऑफ इकोनॉमी। प्रोडक्शन ऑफ द कमोडिटीज लाइक एसी, रेफ्रिजरेटर, कूलर्स, टॉर्च, शैम्पू, ऑयल, गिफ्ट्स, टॉयज, स्केल, मोबाइल, लैपटॉप, टीवी सेट्स, पेन, स्टेशनरी, फैंस, नंबर ऑफ अदर थिंग्स आर देयर इन द इकोनॉमी एंड द सर्विसेज लाइक चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट, डॉक्टर्स, इंजीनियर्स, कोबलर्स, बार्बर्स, फार्मर्स एट्सेट्रा आर ऑल द थिंग्स आर कंज्यूम्ड बाय द पीपल इन द इकोनॉमी टू सेटिस्फाई देयर वॉन्ट्स। सो एन इकोनॉमी इंक्लूड ऑल प्रोडक्शन यूनिट्स सच एज एग्रीकल्चर फार्म्स, फैक्ट्रीज, वर्कशॉप्स, शॉप्स, रेलवेज, बैंकिंग एंड इंश्योरेंस कंपनीज, स्कूल्स, कॉलेजेस, हॉस्पिटल्स एट्सेट्रा विच आर एंगेज इन द टास्क ऑफ प्रोडक्शन गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज फॉर प्रोवाइडिंग सेटिस्फैक्शन ऑफ द ह्यूमन वॉन्ट्स ऑन वन हैंड एंड लिविंग टू द पीपल ऑन द अदर हैंड। नाउ नेक्स्ट वन इज, व्हाट आर द इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज। इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज मीन्स द एक्टिविटीज कंसर्न विद द प्रोडक्शन, डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन एंड द एक्सचेंज ऑफ गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज आर कॉल्ड इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज बिकॉज पीपल डू द वर्क टू अर्न समथिंग। सर्विसेज ऑफ अ टीचर इन अ क्लासरूम, सर्विसेज ऑफ अ डॉक्टर इन द हॉस्पिटल, चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट सर्विसेज इन द ऑफिसेज, सर्विसेज ऑफ अ कारपेंटर एट्सेट्रा आर ऑल कॉल्ड द इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज। नाउ नेक्स्ट वन इज बार्टर सिस्टम। अ फार्मर प्रोड्यूसेस राइस एंड गिव अ पार्ट ऑफ इट टू द कोबलर टू गेट अ पेयर ऑफ शूज। सो बार्टर सिस्टम मीन्स एक्सचेंज हिज गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज विद द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ अदर्स। सो बार्टर सिस्टम इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज सीसी इकोनॉमी। सीसी इकोनॉमी मीन्स वेयर कमोडिटीज आर एक्सचेंज विद द कमोडिटीज। नाउ नेक्स्ट वन इज मॉनेटरी सिस्टम ऑफ एक्सचेंज। सपोज 1 kg ऑफ शुगर इट इज इक्वल्स टू ₹50 एंड 1 shirt इट इज कॉस्ट वर्थ ₹1000। सो वेन द कमोडिटीज आर एक्सचेंज फॉर मनी दैट इज कॉल्ड द मॉनेटरी सिस्टम ऑफ एक्सचेंज। फीचर्स ऑफ एन इकोनॉमी। इकोनॉमिक लाइफ ऑफ अ कम्युनिटी। People's participation in the economic activities like primary activities, secondary activities and tertiary activities. Under the primary activities like agriculture and allied activities like forestry, fishing, quarrying, mining and dairy and sheep rearing also, and number of other primary activities are there. Now next one is secondary activities like activities relating to the manufacturing and construction, manufacturing activities like manufacturing of cement factory and textile mills, bakery products, dairy products, rice mills, thread mill, carpeting, manufacturing and construction of roads, dams, bridges, industries, houses, buildings, etc. So these are secondary activities. Under the tertiary activities, telecommunication services, mass media and hospital, pharmacy, IT, waste disposal, hospitality, industry or the tourism, transport, trade, education, administration, banking, insurance, interest, etc. All these activities are known as the tertiary activities. Now, next one is scarcity of the resources. In each and every economy, there are the resources which are limited like water, sand, coal, forest, and the economy has to use these limited resources to satisfy the human wants. Organization of the consumption. Economy not only related to the production, it relates to the consumption of the available resources. Economy has to use the available resources wisely and in order to maintain the sustainability. Institutions. Institution means such as social, religious, political, legal or economic institutions. Like family, it's a social institution. Government, it's a political institution. Economic institutions like production, trade unions, joint stock companies. ऑल दीज इंस्टीट्यूशंस कंबाइनली इट इज़ कॉल्ड द इकोनॉमी. नेक्स्ट वन इज कोऑर्डिनेशन. इन द इकोनॉमी कोऑर्डिनेशन इट इज़ मस्ट बिकॉज whenever we have to take any decision, first of all we have to plan and accordingly the economies work, otherwise economies are the failures. If suppose we have to control the price, that is known as the price mechanism, it is determination of price with the help of the market forces like demand and supply. Next one is like government present the budget on the parliament table every year with the planning expenditures. So coordination it is must in the economy. Dynamism. Economy is a dynamic, not a static. All the institutions having some rules and regulations, but these rules and regulations are man-made and we can change these rules and regulations according to the requirement anytime. Next one is types of economies. On the basis of ownership of means of production, we will discuss the economies like socialism, capitalism and mixed economy. And on the basis of level of development, there are developed economies, underdeveloped and developing economies. Classification on the basis of the ownership of the means of production, that is first one is capitalism or the capitalistic economy. Capitalistic economy means where there is no interference of the government and the privatization it is there. The private person can purchase its own property and make a use of it for the production process. There are many capitalistic economies like Canada, USA, Mexico, France, UK, Japan, Germany, Australia. So capitalism is based on the free enterprise and non-interference of the government. Under this kind of economic organization, means of production like land, machinery and building are owned by private people. People are free to make use of this wealth and capital. Economic activities of the entrepreneur are guided by self-interest and profit motive. Capitalistic economy is also known as a free market economy and laissez-faire economy. Laissez-faire economy means where there is no interference of the government, and free market economy means where the prices are determined by the market forces of demand and supply. Now next one is features of capitalistic economy. Capitalistic economy first feature it is private property and inheritance. Private property like real estate, buildings, objects, intellectual properties like copyright and patents are there. Everybody has a right to acquire property, private property, and pass it to the next heir, like to his son or daughter or any relatives after death. But right to property is not absolute and unrestricted, because people cannot use the productive resources for producing undesirable goods or illegal goods. Next one is freedom of enterprise and contract. People can choose occupation of their own choice according to their ability and training. For national security, individuals may restrict it to produce certain goods like war goods, public utility services like water, electricity, natural gas and telephone services. Otherwise, people can start any kind of business, like they can start the textile mills also, they can start with the sugar factory also. So any business people can start. Freedom of the consumption. In the capitalistic economy, producer and consumer both are free to decide that how much they have to consume and in what way they have to consume the resources. Next one is free market. Buyers are free to purchase the commodities at the lesser competitive prices, and sellers are also free to enter or exit the market under the capitalistic economies. Profit motive. Under the capitalistic economy, the main goal of the producer is to maximize the profit. Class conflict. In the capitalistic economy, there is always a problem of have and have nots, like rich and poor. Rich have a tendency to exploit the poor, like bigger industries always dominate the small scale industries. Bigger industries launch their products at a lesser rates, at a cheaper rates in the market, and small scale industries can't bear all these losses and they can quit the market. Price mechanism. Producers and consumers take decisions on the basis of the price of the goods and services. If the cost of production for the producer it is more, like the producer has to pay more prices for his production in the form of wages and the payment of raw material, then the cost of production for the producer it is higher and the supply of the goods in the market it is lesser. In the same way, if the prices are higher, the consumer can take the decision to buy less of that commodity with higher prices. So producers and consumers take decision on the basis of the prices of the goods and services. Competition. In the capitalistic economy, there is a competition in the market. So the producer always seeking for the best technology and advanced technology. Laissez-faire states. In the laissez-faire states, there is no interference of the government, or you can say that minimum interference of the government, and the existence of the government is to maintain the law and orders only. Next one is merits of capitalism. First one is abundance of goods. In the capitalistic economy, producers only produce those goods in the economy which are in demand. That's why they produce the goods in bulk and at a cheaper rates. Best resource utilization. Under the capitalism, resources are properly utilized by the producer in order to increase the profit. Technological progress. In the capitalistic economy, the producer always seeking for the advanced technology so that they can provide the cheap and best goods to the customers. Next one is cheap and best goods. Cheap and best goods due to the advancement of the technology, and the consumers are also satisfied with all these. Incentives to the hard work. Under the capitalistic economy, incentives are there for the entrepreneur for the motivation, like increments in the salaries for the best works. Economic freedom. In the capitalistic economy, consumers and producers both can take their own decision. They can make the changes, like producer can make the changes in their production processes, and consumer can change the decisions of that what to purchase and what not to purchase. Increase in the production and standard of living. With the capitalistic economy, there is increase in the production due to the advancement of the technology, cheap and best technology also. With this, GDP of the economy also increases and standard of living of the people in the country also improved. Next one is demerits of the capitalism. Inequality in the distribution of income and wealth. First point is, because in the capitalistic economy, rich becomes more richer and poor becomes more poorer. Next one is class conflict. There is always problem of have and have nots. Rich and poor problem it is there. Bigger industries always dominate the small scale industries. Unemployment. In the capitalistic economies, there is overutilization of resources and abundance of goods in the economy are produced, and there is always a fear of depression in the economy. And that's why there is a unemployment problems, like in America and England. Still, there is a problem of unemployment due to overutilization of resources. Exploitation. Under the capitalism, in order to increase the profit, there is an exploitation of the resources. Like the producers can give lesser wages to the laborers for their services. Wastage of resources. In the capitalistic economy, as competition it is there, and household also ready to discard the old products, old technology. Like if new cell phones are there in the market, the household will discard the old one and buy the new one. In the same way, for the new car models are there, new laptops are there, new computers are there, new watches are there. So all these are just mere wastage of resources. Economic fluctuations. If in the economy nothing it is planned, everything it is unplanned, that economy it is a failure. Next one is self-interest in place of social welfare. Under the capitalistic economy, capitalist always, or the private person or the entrepreneur, always seeking for the maximization of the profit and not bother for the welfare of the economy. Next one is unbalanced development. Under the capitalistic economy, the producer will always produce or start business in those areas where there is a maximum profit he can earn, and other areas are untouched or not developed. So some resources in this way are untouched. So hope students you have understood the topic. It's time to note down the homework. First one is explain the capitalistic economy, also explain its merits and demerits. Next one is define the following terms: economy, laissez-faire policy, capitalism. Students, please go through the links for more clarity. Thank you for listening.